be a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
Now this is familiar enough.
Go for it, Laura. Test your royalty.
No King of England jokes, Alistair. I probably have to turn on the power first. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Word. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
And we have power.
Hey, now that the power's on, maybe you can go back and pull out Excalibur.
It's not Excalibur! The sword in the stone and Excalibur were two different bloody swords! Arthur got Excalibur after the sword in the stone broke in his battle with Pelennor! Oh, good grief, nobody gets it straight!
That's because nobody cares.
Boys.
Sorry.
Between stupid and charming with you, is there?
Thus didst King Arthur gather round his person ye greatest knights of ye realm, that they might be paragons of chivalry and virtue. Gaily they cased, yea, and 'twas an assembly as hadst not before been seen of, and verily there was much rejoicing.
Hey, push the button again. It's like electroshock therapy for Alistair.
I like to think it keeps him sharp.
So that there wouldst be no squabbling betwixt ye knights, Merlin bequeathed upon Arthur yon round table, which was the table neither square nor buttressed, but circular in form. 'Twas a symbol of unity and equality, and 'twas where Arthur's knights took their name. The Knights of the Round Table.
I'm assuming you're taking notes.
Yeah, verily.
Behold ye Holy Grail! Such a vision of yon cup of Christ didst verily appeareth to Arthur and his knights, whereupon several amongst them didst quest for to find it unknown.
Really?
Never trust a woman?
Don't believe in magic.
For hours did Arthur and Mordred hackle upon Salisbury Plain. Arthur with Excalibur, Mordred with its scabbard. Then it was that both were disarmed, and Arthur did strike Mordred a fatal blow with the spear of Sir Bedivere. Anon came more tragedy, for Arthur was himself mortally wounded in ye battle.
There's a logical explanation for that. It's called evening.
You're so literal, Alistair. Archaeology is half metaphor, you know.
Before he did die, Arthur badest his knight Bedivere to returneth Excalibur to yon lady of ye lake. And lo, this Arthur's body then slumber. And yea, it was borne away to Avalon.
Well, if he went to Avalon, then whose tomb's supposed to be here?
Maybe the grunting Saxon or the Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained, but it's been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth everywhere else, why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close an exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. This must be our kindly professor's office space.
Dunlap as spottily as his reputation.
Said the pot to the kettle. Professor Worth says here that the tomb of King Arthur, the one his museum's built over, is a fake.
No surprise there. At least he knows his museum is for tourists.
But Professor Worth believed the sarcophagus was placed here by Arthur's contemporaries to lure thieves from the gravesite of the actual King Arthur.
Who doesn't exist?
That's where you and the professor differ. This definitely isn't Arthur's tomb.
We knew that already.
What's wrong with it?
I've seen enough tombs in my life to know when I'm looking at a cenotaph.
Say who?
A diversion. This place is trying too hard. It's hiding something.
A body?
No, that's the problem. Better.
Nice. Be careful. You don't want to demolish anything important.
Really? I have a velvet in it. But I'm glad to see now that there's something good. Please, Alistair. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore. safely.
So am I.
That doesn't mean you don't have to be quiet anymore. There's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take. Maybe there's a way up and over.
This looks like my garbage disposal.
I hope you're not leaping through there, Laura. There must be a way to stop them up.
I certainly hope so.
you're long jumping that.
No, I'll have to make a path. But it might have been worth trying just to hear you lads squeal about it. Something I could move.
You could move that.
This looks relatively fragile.
time to adjust some travel arrangements I made. It shouldn't take too long.
Coward. Don't worry, Lara. I've still got an eye on you. Probably won't be able to hear each other too well when you're underwater, though.
There is a god.
Hey, I heard that.
This is brilliant.
That is interesting.
Real. They're all here. The court of Camelot.
You're sure about this? King Arthur, who wast verily of ye loins of Uther Pendragon?
I've no doubt about the authenticity of this tomb, Alistair. Arthur was the 11th century figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Laura.
Excalibur. The sword in the stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps? Says Bedivere returned a fragment of Excalibur to Arthur after the other pieces were carried off by the knights.
Where did they go?
To find Avalon, perhaps. The quest for the Holy Grail. Lancelot, Galahad, Percival, and Bors. Their tombs are empty.
It says this fragment was left with Arthur to help him leave this mausoleum when the time came. Perhaps it will help me instead. Arthur Pendragon, King of the Britons. I wouldn't take Excalibur if I didn't need it so. I hope you can forgive me.
Mara, there's something going on up here. Alistair, you see that?
See what? Oh, hell! Get your hands!
Zip! Hey. Alistair!
Let go! Lara!
Zip, what's happening?
We'll be right back.
Hello, lads.
Hey, Lara. What's up?
They didn't make off with your credit cards, did they? Is everything all right? Alistair?
I'm fine. Just not my usual evening routine.
Then let's go home.